Never to see the pupils of Marcus Gone, or also called relative afferent pupillary reflex defect. And so we have the eyes. We are going to test the pupillary reflex. So we put light on this eye, and it will be transmitted. Or what is going to do the reflex, the afferent limb of the reflex are the ganglionic neurons, the optic nerve, but just the lateral ganglionic neurons of the lateral retina. This will do synapses on the pretectal nucleus. From here, they do bilateral synapses on the Edinger-Westphal nucleus that are in the midbrain. This is the parasympathetic nucleus of the oculomotor nerve. Then the oculomotor nerve goes to the ciliary ganglion. These are the preganglionic neurons. The ciliary ganglion is the parasympathetic ganglion, and the postganglionic neuron goes to the pupillary sphincter constrictor muscle. The neurotransmitters that are involved are in the preganglionic neuron to the postganglionic neuron, that is the neurotransmitter that is released in the ganglion, is acetylcholine, and is received by nicotinic acetylcholine receptors. Then this neuron is releasing to the pupillary sphincter muscle constrictor. It's releasing again acetylcholine, but now to metabotropic acetylcholine receptors that are GQ protein associated receptors. And at the end we have constriction of both pupils. Marcus Gone pupils are seen in every pathological process that damage the optic nerve. So there is defect in the afferent pupillary reflex, the afferent limb of the pupillary reflex. The afferent limb is by the optic nerve. The efferent limb is by the oculomotor nerve. So there is defect in the afferent limb of the pupillary reflex. So the light that is put on the eye is not going to be perceived by the eye that has optic nerve damage. So there will be no constriction of the pupils, of any one of the pupils. If we put light on the unaffected eye, we will see constriction of both pupils. If we then put again light on the affected eye, we will see that the pupils are returning to the normal state. They were constricted when we put light here, and then they are returning, dilating to the normal state when we put light on the unaffected eye, because we are just taking out the light on this eye, and the patient is not perceiving light on this eye. So it's like we were not putting light, so here we will not see constriction anymore, and we will see this paradoxical dilation. These are called Marcus Gone pupils, or relative afferent pupillary reflex defect, and is seen in any condition that affects the optic nerve. If it is bilateral, we could not see this apparent dilation, because if both optic nerves are damaged in any eye, we will not see constriction of the pupils. But in bilateral Marcus Gone pupils, we suspect of multiple sclerosis.